Thank you, Emilia. Good afternoon, good evening, good morning. Depends where you are. So we are I'm very pleased to be here and to talk to you on behalf of UITP, the International Association of Public Transport. And I would like to congratulate, of course, UN Habitat, UCLG, and Metropolis for taking this initiative. And I am very happy on behalf of UITP of our collaboration with all of you. UITP represents 1,800 organizations in 100 countries, and our members regulate, operate, supply services and equipment for local and regional public transport worldwide. And as you know, mobility in cities has been impacted tremendously in the context of the COVID-19 crisis. The lockdown that has been enforced for 4 billion inhabitants has prevented most people to move. This is, in a way, very good, as it means people are staying home and hopefully staying safe. But on the other hand, it had an important impact on public transport ridership. In some cities, we registered about 90% less ridership than in an usual time. So, and this decreased ridership came with unprecedented financial challenges for public transport organizations. Nevertheless, it's important that we ensure the continuity of public transport services due to the vital role of public transport for the society and the economy, and especially for the many individuals who depend on a well-functioning system and must travel to execute their essential daily functions. So this will ensure that the health crisis doesn't turn into a social crisis. This is very important. And it's with this in mind that UITP, UCLG, ITF, the International Transport Worker Federation, and UIC, the International Rail Union, have signed today a joint statement. And I am happy to talk a little bit about this statement, because first, we are very proud of this collaboration with our partners, because it involves all public transport stakeholders, the operators, the authorities, the supplying industry, the workers and the local governments officials. So, and it covers all modes of transport. And the message of this statement is very clear. So first, we remind the crucial role public transport plays in the context of the pandemic and the necessity to ensure the continuity of the service. And second, we call national governments and competent authorities to guarantee the supply of appropriate protective equipment and products to public transport and local mobility operators. And unfortunately, we see in many cities that the transport operators, they don't have this equipment at their disposal because it doesn't exist in the country. There is no enough availability in the country. And third, to deploy exceptional measures, including financial support, to ensure the continuity of services during the crisis and post-crisis to swiftly resume regular operations once the COVID-19 is under control. And this financial support must also be targeted towards the preservation of jobs, of course, and similar measures are needed to support the supply industry to get through the crisis. But at the same time, we are also doing our homework as public transport stakeholders, and I would like to mention just some examples. It's about ensuring all workers receive the latest and most accurate information about COVID-19, then provide the staff in all occupational groups with adequate personal protective equipment. It's about regular cleaning and disinfecting of public transport vehicles, workplaces, and stations. It's about limiting the interaction of drivers and other occupations with passengers. It's about also adapting the level of service according to the reduction of travel demand to ensure service continuity, and social distancing. And this is one of the challenges. And of course, and very important, is to provide dedicated services to healthcare personnel. So what I would like to say in conclusion is that this crisis has shown more than ever than how public transport is vital in order to keep key workers moving, in particular those who save lives and those who keep the basic services running for all citizens. We must all feel proud to serve this sector. We serve those who serve. And this is a noble mission for public transport. So I would like to say this opportunity of the participation of unions and workers' representations in this session to thank once more all the public transport workers who are our guardians of mobility, or professionally and providing
reflection on it was that
service. So it's important that we all remain committed to advocating for public transport as a vital public service during these unprecedented times. Thank you very much for your attention, and I look forward to the discussions and the presentation that will follow. Thank you.